Hi guys, this is Ramkrishna. Explain you for second normal form here. As earlier videos, I have given you first normal form. Extend it to that, talking about the second normal form here. But basically normal forms can help you to reduce the redundancy in the relation. So in this context, explain you a second normal form with a proper examples. So when we can say a relation R is in the second normal form, the relation should be following these two conditions. The basic and first condition is the table or a relation must be in the first normal form. So when we can say the relation R is in the first normal form, and every field of R must contains only atomic values as for the first normal form. So the input for the second normal form, a relation, the relation must be in the first normal form. As for the rules of the first normal form, every field in the relation must contains atomic values. Fine. So then the second condition in the second normal form is no partial dependency. So let me explain you here what exactly a partial dependency with very simple way. Like you can assume there is a relation R, it may contains attributes like A, B, C, D. Assume that there is a functional dependency AB derives C. So this is a functional dependency. Let us observe either it is a partial dependency or not. So here AB derives C. C is functionally dependent on AB. So when we can say it is a partial dependency, again D derives C. So it means in this functional dependency is a candidate key, any subset of this also dependent by C, then this is called as partial dependency. Let us see this way, A, B, C, another example, A, B, C derives, for example, D. So the D is functionally dependent on A, B, C. The same D also dependent on subset of this A, B, C. What is the subset of A, B, C? A, B, A, C. These two are the subset of A, B, C. So then again A, B derives D. So again D also dependent on A, B. Also dependent on AC. So then we can say this functional dependency is partial functional dependency. So in the second normal form, there should not be any partial functional dependencies. Clear? So this is another way we can mention second normal form. No partial dependency, but it must be a full functional dependency. Full functional dependency. It must be exist full functional dependency. What exactly? This is another way. Another way. For example, we can see when we can say this is a full functional dependency, let us take R is a relation. It contains A, B, C, D are the attributes. A comma B comma C comma D are the attributes. So in this case, there is a dependency existed. Assume that A, B, C derives D. A, B, C derives D. This D is functionally dependent on A, B, C. But again, this D does not dependent on any subset of this. Any subset of this. Then we can say it is full functional dependency. When we can say it is full functional dependency. So it means it is indirectly can say, whenever we can take a functional dependency, this must be a candidate key. This should not be a primary key. Then obviously it holds full functional dependency. If it should not be a prime attribute, and this must be a candidate key or primary key. So then it holds the full functional dependency. So basically we are talking about the second normal form with a proper way. If there is a relation R, is in the second normal form, it must be a first normal form and no partial dependency, or in other way we can say it must be a full functional dependency. I explained you here what exactly a partial dependency and full functional dependency. If it is a partial dependency, if there is a functional dependency A, B, C derives D, D is dependent on A, B, C, but this D should not again dependent on any subset of A, B, C. Example of A, B is subset of this, D is again dependent. So then we can say this is a partial dependent. When we can say it is a full dependence, then there is no dependency in the this dependency. It should not be D dependent on any other subset of this candidate key. Then we can say this is full functional dependency. So it means indirectly say all this non-key attributes are functionally dependent on key attributes. This is indirectly say. So this is the example, a simple example to understand about the second normal form. Thank you.